Welcome to another episode of the Team Elmer's Update, where we take you past the orange barrels and onto the job site.
The Runway 1028 project is a project that we've been really working on here at Cherry Capital Airport since the 1960s. When the runway was first developed, it was designed for what was the new jet air, so a 6,500 foot runway. Shortly thereafter, all airports across the country realized that the runways needed to be longer for many different reasons. Capacity reasons, safety reasons. As we went through the 80s and 90s, and even into the early 2000s, we started to realize as our passengers were utilizing the airport, the more they filled the airplanes. What we needed to do is maximize the capacity of those aircraft at our peak time, which is our summertime, but also is our hottest time. So the hotter the temperature, the more runway length the aircraft needs due to the density of the air. Because it's less dense, we need to ensure that we have a longer runway that will be adequate to take a full load of passengers to our major hub destinations. Our large commercial jets like the DC-9 and the MD-80 are displacing 14, 15 passengers at a time. That doesn't seem much when you look at it from a single flight, but when you add it up over the years, it was thousands and thousands of passengers. And so that's not only angry passengers, but that's lost revenue to the airlines. So we did a lot of planning and analysis, and we realized we needed to be over 7,000 feet. The first phase that we took on of construction was 2013, where we did 400 feet towards the east or towards Three Mile Road. And then this phase, we added 115 feet, and then we resurfaced the entire length of the runway.
There are two sections that required a full reconstruction, and that was the far west end of the runway, and then there's a section in the middle of the runway where the old Air Force runway used to run through. Ended up doing a full removal for 800 feet and then regrading it out so it should be a smoother landing. Then with the extension, we had to regrade the entire field and rework that section to make sure the grades matched out.
Construction began August 9th and continued through the beginning of November. The project included resurfacing 1 1/3 mile of runway that's roughly 18 car lanes wide, including the 800-foot reconstruct. P209, a variation of an M-DOT aggregate mixture, was used as a subbase, while specialized asphalt mixtures known as P401 and P403 were used for the runway surface. The perimeter road surrounding the property was also updated, as well as the runway lighting, which was completed by J-Rank Electric.
The way the bid was put together, we put a lot of planning into it. We knew going in that there was going to be a time that was crunch time. It was very important to find a contractor that could do the mission and do it correctly and on time. That those contractors knew that when they bid this, that it was a job that required a lot of attention and a lot of details. And also personnel.
Overall, it was about 6 months worth of work that we did in 30 days. If you look at the volume of work that needed to be done at the start of this and then looked at the time frames, you know, you kind of start off with a, how are we going to get this done type feeling, but you just kind of break it down into smaller sections.
In order to fit such a large amount of work into such a condensed time frame, a different approach needed to be taken when scheduling the project.
The only difference with this project rather than every other project is you're working 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. You're doubling your crew size, and so it's every track you're laying out in front of you is just that much shorter because we're working at that fast of a pace. So you break things down into shifts, into days, nights, hours, minutes in some parts of it. If you try and look at the whole mountain in front of you and not just the step you have to take, it becomes overwhelming. But the more you break it down, the more you get a sense for what you need for resources, kind of eating the elephant one bite at a time. We got into it, the milling was hard. We ended up having to split the mill crews up and bring in people from the office and outside resources and that. You just keep throwing everything you got at it because you don't have time to turn around and step backwards once you've started. The planning process doesn't end until you're done with the project, and even then you're still trying to find better ways to do it or different ways to do it. And the knowledge and resources we have from the guys in the field, the people in the office, and the folks surrounding us is really invaluable.
Almost 80%, 85% of the project was done in those 21 days. I think the biggest unknown going into bidding is who would be able to deliver on all the planning that was put in place. I mean, out of the major portion of the construction, and Elmer's delivered that. And that was, you know, probably the biggest asset to this entire program, to this project, is to see that on time of something that was very difficult to do. We had a lot of fortunate aspects of weather that went our way, equipment operating, you know, no major breakdowns or failures, you know. And so when you really look at that all coming together, it comes back to the people and the people delivering on what they do best at. And it was really appreciated on this project.
Thanks for tuning in to another episode of the Team Elmer's Update. As always, stay safe out there. We'll see you next time. Don't forget to subscribe, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook. And check out TeamElmers.com for more project information.